Good morning. So I'm at the services on the A34 South Oxfordshire at the Milton Interchange Junction, and I thought I'd do a video about the EV charging at this services. So here obviously we've got a BP petrol station here, there's a couple of chargers there which I'll show you. We've got a McDonalds behind, you've got a Beefeater here with a Premier Inn, and then over on the other side of the road is a Miller and Carter Steakhouse, Costa Coffee, and lots of car garages. So just here we've got two rapid chargers, and this chap here has just been charging, and as you can see he's got a caravan and he's just about to attach it back up. So here there are two DC rapid chargers with two charging bays, and on both you've got CCS and CHAdeMO, and it's 150 kilowatt CCS and 100 kilowatt CHAdeMO. And the price of these today is 59 pence per kilowatt hour for fast charging and 79 pence per kilowatt hour for rapid and ultra rapid charging. I've never used them, so I don't know where the threshold is, what the difference between fast and rapid, but I'm sure you'll let me know in the comments below. So the other chargers at this location, around the back in the McDonald's car park. And then over here in the McDonald's car park is two Instavolt chargers. So two charging bays. These have both got CCS and CHAdeMO. 120 kilowatt CCS, 50 kilowatt CHAdeMO. And the price of these currently in August is 75 pence per kilowatt hour with a pre-authorisation value of £30. And what I've found actually is these two chargers here are often unused and quiet, whereas the BP ones on the other side of that hedge, there's often a queue. However, there are some more chargers coming to this site, and I'm in the back of the Premier Inn car park now, and for weeks this area has been fenced off, but it looks like they've just done the groundworks now for a couple of charging bays here. And these are going to be some Genie Point chargers. So this is the barriers, and as you can see it says haywoodev.com, and the whole area here has been fenced off for quite a few weeks or months now actually, and they'd fenced off this whole area, so I thought it looked like there was going to be quite a decent bank of chargers, and it, because of the size, I thought it was going to be rapid chargers. However, as you can see, it's only going to be one unit there, so I assume now that's actually just going to be a double-headed AC charger, which sort of makes sense for a hotel, because the customers of this site are going to be staying overnight in the hotel, or at least staying for a few hours eating in the Beefeater. So AC charging makes sense at a location like this. But putting any two bays in 2023 really isn't good enough, but of course there's always a power constraint potentially on sites like this, but I'm sure they could have done more than two bays. So I've now come to the other side of the road where the Costa is. However, if you're in that services and you want to get here, you've got to go back up to the main A34 roundabout, come round to get across here, because you cannot cross the road. But anyway, it's not a big problem. So here we've got Costa. There is a whole suite of garages which are all owned by Marshalls. So you've got Volkswagen, Seat and Cupra, and then here you've got a huge Land Rover and Jaguar dealership. So along here in the Miller and Carter car park is another rapid charger. This one's been here for years. This was previously a harvester at this site. And here we have a BP Charge Master rapid charger. So here we have a 50 kilowatt CCS, 50 kilowatt CHAdeMO, and we've got AC, and this is 43 kilowatt AC power on a type 2. So not many of those left since GridServe changed all the Ecotricity pumps. 43 kilowatt AC has pretty much disappeared from the UK, apart from a few locations like this where older charger units are still remaining. So the prices of this are just the same on the other side of the road at the BP station, standard BP pricing. A word of warning though, if you come to this site and use that single rapid charger there, You do need to go into the restaurant and put your number plate on the screen, otherwise you will be hit with a parking fine, which is why I've parked there on the double yellow lines outside of the car park. So just as I was leaving, turning the car around, I noticed there's a couple of chargers here in the Jaguar Land Rover dealership. So obviously these won't be for customer use, but if you're really stuck, then there's a potential that you could use these if you go and ask nicely, possibly. So there's a CCS connector there. I don't know what these units are, but I would imagine that could be a 25 kilowatt DC charger, one of the sort of cheaper low powered chargers. And here we've got a charge master post with 32 amp, it says, so 7 kilowatt and a 7 kilowatt AC type 2. This requires an RFID card, as does this one as well. So obviously these two aren't for public use, but I thought I'd include it in the video just because it's all on the same site here. So that's all the EV charging on the A34 services at the Milton Lodge. Well, it's now called Milton Lodge. We used to call it Milton Heights, but the Milton Interchange here on the A34. So I hope you found that useful. If you have, please do click the thumbs up button. It really does help. Do subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next video.